badge says hybrid. The important thing to know about the Chrysler Pacifica Hybrid right off the bat is this: it's actually a FEV. You plug it in, and it runs on electricity for the first 7 miles of your day. As I found during a week at the wheel of the electrified minivan, if you have the right commuting or parking situation, you might find yourself using little or no gasoline. It's noteworthy Chrysler is the first automaker to put a FEV minivan on sale in America for a brand with only 3 models in its showroom nowadays. This was an even bigger home run than the non-hybrid Pacifica that birthed it. The hybrid takes a great, competitive minivan and makes it truly special, even buzzworthy. Best of all, it's the kind of plug-in vehicle that just makes sense for a huge number of families. It's not much more expensive than any comparably equipped competitive minivan, yet it gets an EPA estimated 84. It's remarkable because the Pacifica Hybrid squeezes that kind of efficiency out of a big, practically sized, attractive family hauler instead of a small, burglary-styled car wrought with compromises. From the outside, there's little to differentiate the Pacifica Hybrid from other Pacifica minivans. That's part of the appeal. You're not driving some weird-looking special model. Though it does have a hybrid Badger 3, they're not trying too hard to draw attention to the electrified powertrain. It will haul 7 passengers in true comfort, and there's an ample cargo area of 32.3 cubic feet behind the third row. It's not trying to look like a sporty wagon. Wink wink. Honda Odyssey, but it's also not a boring, utilitarian box on wheels. The Pacifica was so much better engineered that it made me forget all about those previous disappointments. The electric motors, there are two, make enough power on their own to keep the pace with in-town traffic and even drive 70 miles per hour on the highway for several miles in near silence. I was always able to squeeze about 30 to 35 miles out of the batteries, even when I did a long hill climb to take my boys to school. When the vehicle depletes its all-electric range, it defaults to hybrid mode, which makes the Pacifica Hybrid behave like a big Toyota Prius. The 10.1-inch screens were tablet-like touchscreens and featured games like checkers and a modern take on the age-old license plate game. Chrysler did a great thing when it put a plug-in hybrid powertrain in the Pacifica. I already liked the Pacifica based on my test drive of the non-hybrid version, but the Pacifica Hybrid made me fall in love. This is the kind of practical FEV America needs. It is my sincere hope that the auto industry takes the lessons learned in the Pacifica Hybrid and applies them to more vehicles in more segments. I didn't realize how little gasoline I would need, even with a relatively modest 33-mile electric range. What if a next-gen Pacifica Hybrid has a 50-mile electric range thanks to improved battery chemistry? Or but if Chrysler puts a big lump of batteries in the hole where the engine goes and gives us a 300-mile range on the Pacifica F someday? The future is looking exciting. If you're shopping for a family hauler, I cannot recommend this enough. Test drive a Pacifica Hybrid for about the price of a midsize or large crossover SUV. You can have a much more practical vehicle that will slash your gasoline expenses. My tester had an MSRP of $47,885. The federal tax incentive would bring my net cost down to just a shade over $40,000. That's a pretty strong deal in a world where it is easy to find yourself shopping GMC Acadias or Nissan Pathfinders that often sell for around $40,000 with a few options.